ladies and gentlemen, I am the Dutchman, and today we are starting a very small series, which is going to be a small tutorial for how to properly get started in Galactic Conquest. Say, a tutorial for how to play the Empire at War Remake mod. Now, this is based on the actual full version of the mod, but I will be playing the single-player start No Underworld, just like the light release has, and we're going to be starting a medium game as the Empire on Tech 2. Yeah, that's ready to go. Okay, so basically what this tutorial is intending to do is, it's for the people, and I've been getting a lot of these. People have been asking, Dutchman, Geronimo, whatever they're saying, these massive 17 and 19 kilometer long star dreadnoughts like the Executor, like the Eclipse, are so expensive. They cost like 400,000 credits, 600,000 credits. How is my 10 planet empire ever going to build these huge starships? And the answer is, they're not. You're going to need a large empire to support these gargantuan, these very, very large projects. Now, in this tutorial, I will show you how to properly get yourself started, even on a one planet start. And how to, well, basically get your GC off to a flying start. So there's no underworld here. Again, this is the full version of the mod. This isn't the light version. This is still in development, by the way. If you do want to support the mod, by the way, go check out the Patreon link in the description. I do have a Patreon to keep myself going. This is my job. The Rebels start on Yavin 4. I start on Coruscant. I don't need a hypervelocity cannon. We're just going to sell that. First things first, you want a couple of mines to get yourself going. You can only build 3 mines per planet, so keep that in mind. Planets in the mod have a very varied income amount. A planet like Coruscant should have only about 1,000 income, since it is a urban sprawl planet. Those get 1,000 credits per tick. Other planets, like for example Typhon, that is a forest planet. Frisia is oceanic, which is 200. Temperate, like Anaxis, is 500. There's quite a few temperate planets in the core world of 500, so you definitely want to take off the core worlds as fast as you can. Now, there is one very important strategic objective that you're always going to have to keep in mind, and that is Bespin. Bespin is the only gas giant in the mod, and it it's not the only gas giant, but it's the only one with the set income for it. And it gives you 1500 per tick, which means that anything built here will give you a significant income boost. Now, as I said, we're going to start off with these 3 mines, because they are going to be the backbone of your economy. Now, you're also going to get the gas trading depot. Now, the gas trading depot is going to get you a significant amount of extra cash. If you look at the income, you can see that it gives you 550 extra. The mines will only get you about 150, I think, on Coruscant. Maybe a bit higher, we'll see. But yeah, the name of the game in the Empire at War Remake is expansion. You have to expand your empire. You cannot run an efficient empire on like 10 planets. That's simply not going to work. What we're going to do is we're going to build a couple of probe droids to identify the best target. Now, these build fairly quickly. What you're seeing here, by the way, are the freighters, which cost a absolute metric fuck ton of command points, but they also give you extra income. Now, you will see in the description, for example, the YT-1300 gives you 4% of base planet income, which on Coruscant is 1,000, so you would get 40 income per freighter. It takes 10 turns to pay off. The GR-75, the Gallo Free, brings in 15, so that's a lot better. But it's also more expensive, and it takes a lot more command points. Now, the way this is balanced is the higher the income of the freighters, the more population points they take. And they do take a lot of population points. So you really gotta be... Okay, one Venator, one Recusant. What does this have?
Construction complete.
Okay, see, that's a little bit lighter. So we're probably gonna go for that. Yeah, I want all this here. You can come in as well. I'm gonna start with a Quasar, because this is simply gonna give me a little bit of income. Now, I don't know if the freighters are actually enabled in the light build. I kind of forgot. But you don't need... You know what? I'm not gonna build any freighters. I'm gonna show you that you can do this without any freighters.
Tactical battle imminent.
Just as it is in the Enlightened release. Freighters you could build once you have a gas depot, of course.
ready for your orders.
Alright, so we're just going to go through this quickly. This is not supposed to be a very
Let's show these dissidents who rules this galaxy. Remove their influence from the system by destroying all their defenses.
Ready for action, sir.
Hover over the units that you've got. They've all got accurate descriptions. They say stats. They say what ships are good against, what ships are not
Cruiser
good against.
Reporting.
The strengths, their weaknesses, so you should have no problem with
Cruiser
that.
Here.
Again, I'm gonna... Oh, nice, Acclimator
Reporting
2.
In.
I do love the Acclimator line of Starship, especially for the Empire. The Acclimator 2 and 3 are so powerful. Especially the 3. That's even useful in late-game assaults. That thing's got so much shield-penetrating firepower.
Enemy forces ahead!
Right, so as I said, this is going to be mostly a tutorial for
Cruiser reporting.
GC, so I am going to speed through this rather quickly.
Attacking!
Get this down, probably not. Try. Might have to get these Corvettes out of here. But the Vigils do have the small rocket launcher, so I'm hoping that they can do enough damage to the shield generator to take that down.
I've got one on me. Awaiting command. Awaiting your command. Location confirmed. Cannons armed.
Just gonna get out of here, or...
Yes, Commander.
Deal with this.
Fire for maximum effect.
I've got them in my sights.
Now, you're going to see me auto-resolve a lot, because this is, as I said, supposed to be a tutorial or a walkthrough. Depending on how you want to see this. Maybe I should give the Acclimator Blue to Rangers. Due to them being a rebel ship of a Republic ship and all. Ah, shit, right, I've got Tarkin here, so I can't actually order resolve.
Ready, sir.
That's unfortunate.
What are you waiting for? Annihilate them!
Great question, what are we waiting for?
Attack formation.
Alright, so a little bit more about the actual remake mod itself and the way it differs from standard Empire at War. You can only build 3 mines on each planet. Now, that's a little bit different than vanilla Empire at War, of course, where you can
build
limited amounts of mines.
I will allow you
and it really changed the economy system. There's also the change that planets now give a very high amount of base income, at least depending on, as I said, what type of planet. Is it temperate? Is it urban? That sort of stuff. Mines
we
also give less
victorious.
Income per mine, so if you build a gas trading depot and a... Colonel. Right, so...
Construction complete.
That's about I am going to auto-resolve this. Okay, so... As I said, mines give less income per... Let's see, how much does Corson get again? Right, 150. Okay. So mines give 15% income.
Building canceled.
The gas depot. The gas depot you can only build if you already have a level 1 station, and space stations are very expensive, but they are totally worth it. Probably gonna go for a Nexus later. Oh, that's nothing. Well, I say that, but that's actually... It's not bad. Get you in there. So yeah, you really want to start expanding as quickly as you can. Of course, go for the 500 planets if you can. Keep in mind, Bespin is a high priority target, but you are going to have to go through Typhara and Yagdol to actually get there. My apologies. You're going to be wiping out a lot of pirates in the first couple of turns. Actually, for quite a significant amount of time, you're going to be wiping out pirates. But they do have very varied fleets, and when you do eventually encounter the Rebel Alliance, they will be
this
quite
pitiful
powerful
force is
and
preventing our assault on the system.
Have captured
dispatch them so that we can secure orbit for the Empire.
A very significant fleet to battle with. Now again, there have been a lot of people that have simply misunderstood
the
economy system. They don't quite understand that you have to really expand and that you cannot build Star Dreadnoughts on, like, sitting on 5 planets and just defending. These are very, very large projects and things like the Death Star take a lot of... I should not
be able to do this.
TIE Interceptor here. Course set. For the Empire. Commencing attack run. Changing course to intercept.
Yes.
Now again, as I said, this is the full version of the mod.
I'm here.
But it's actually fairly equal to the light release. So even though this may not be necessarily representative of what you're going to find in the light release, it's going to be similar enough that everything done here will also work. Again, the freighters I will not build.
Battery is online.
Need them. They're simply a way to add income. Ready. On them. Not even sure if they were.
Bomber standing by. On target. Bomber squadron
light
reporting.
Release.
Setting up my
again,
run, sir. Engines
them.
Activated.
And they are causing some AI issues. Namely, the AI are building the freighters and sending them to battle.
Intercepting.
They are not supposed to be warships, so that's still something.
Pursuing enemy forces.
Standing by. Ready, sir.
I've got one on me.
Yes, sir. Attacking.
I love
you. Move to attack.
They have so much firepower. Those torpedoes are quadruple lasers of the Acclimator 2 are also very powerful.
Move to attack.
So useful for hunting your confidence.
Navigating.
It really is an assault ship. In Vanilla Empire at
what
war,
are your orders?
Really...
Ready for orders.
Can we auto-assault this?
Take
I don't want to suddenly lose all my
target at maximum firepower.
Thanks to a faulty auto-assault. And as we do know, auto-assault is very finicky.
The enemy has been defeated.
I may do that more often in the future. So now that we've got the Abogado Ray, now you may ask, why am I not immediately expanding into the Galactic Core itself, like the Nexus, Alderaan? Speaking of which, let me build some more probe droids to see what's up
vehicle
there.
Vehicle in production. Construction
what
complete.
What else do we want? We can't
construct
these.
Vehicle in production.
ATST is always useful, of course.
Building started.
Coordinates received.
Now, being locked in by the pirates like this has another advantage. Namely, you are not being attacked by the rebels right away. So you are not being harassed and you can kind of do your own thing at your own pace, but you do really need to get going.
Building
I'm going to build one mine here and just the gas depot.
Beginning construction.
Does this have the... No, not yet. And then we're going to
building
start.
Started.
I usually build a garrison of like 5 ATSTs on a planet, and that usually
complete.
Works. Anything heavier, you can build a... You can build the artillery. Also, why am I not going immediately for Kuat? I will show you. Ah, I can take that.
As the Emperor wills.
Now, the Kuat defense fleet is actually quite sizable. Not only does it have the Venator and, I think, 2 Acclimator 1s. Yeah, Acclimator 1s. It also has an ISD-1, which is very, very powerful, of course. So you really want to be careful, and that's not an early game
tactical
target that you want to go for. I can't auto-resolve these space battles, I don't think, so I'm just going to do it manually. You do get a sizable fleet at the start of the GC, which you can use to start capturing planets with. You can't actually start producing a lot of
ready for your orders.
Not just capitals,
what
yes.
is your order?
Frigates on your
by
own,
way,
because you can't
let's show
fund
these
that
dissidents who rules this galaxy.
You got. If
remove
you're starting
their
with a 10-planet
from the
GC,
system by destroying all their defenses.
If you're starting with the 10-planet GC, then you can clearly just start building mines and gas depots everywhere and very easily get your income up and from there,
there
on
they are.
Expand.
Lots
but of course, the enemy will also
yes,
have
Commander.
This. The one-planet start is really...
standing by.
Yeah, let's start full
fire
firepower
for maximum effect.
Otherwise, you're never going to
roger
kill
that.
These are so, so annoying.
Form up.
Okay, so this is what I'm going to use to screen the fighters, hopefully, once I find them.
Awaiting orders.
Weapons ready.
Copy.
Enemies
right,
in range.
Interceptor squad reporting. Acquiring target.
I copy.
Of course, Corvettes in the mod are fairly tanky, so they can take quite a bit of damage.
Orders, sir.
You don't have to fear losing them immediately.
Advancing on target.
I say that as that thing gets completely shrecked.
Yes, sir. Confirm.
Of course, they're not
forward.
Exceptionally tanky. They do still take a lot of damage.
I can't see. Ready for orders.
Yeah.
Take down their shields.
You presume too much.
Yes, Commander.
You want to be a little careful, of course.
Ready, sir.
You don't
ready
need to get
orders.
That close to engage. Not you. Not you.
Direct fire at their laser cannons. Yes, sir. Navigating to coordinates.
TIE squadron here. TIE's reporting here.
Don't sit there doing nothing. You don't want to use your gladiator in combat. Of course, these are carriers. They're not warships.
Your order, sir?
If you want a warship, build a acclimator or something. These are far,
the missile
far
launchers are the primary target. Target confirmed. Destroy the torpedo launcher.
Yes, sir. He won't be around.
Direct fire on those torpedoes.
Ready for orders. Target at maximum firepower.
Luckily, the off-charge ability does come back very quickly.
Launching attack.
What is your order?
It's very useful, especially for the larger Star Destroyers.
Target those lasers.
I will try.
Not every ship has it.
Ready for battle.
That still has full shields, attack which position. Is difficult to get through, even with the overcharge, or we'll just use the missiles for victory. Ah, never mind. The main batteries of the Prong Crusader are more than enough to get through the shields. Which again, very light frigates and corvettes are disproportionately powerful, as in they've got so much health.
We are victorious.
They can actually survive quite a bit, and it does take quite a bit of bombing from a frigate to actually get through total amount of HP. Now that we've got Alderaan, we are going to once again take all our ground
complete.
Forces and it go there.
Construction complete.
Right, we got that. Okay, we have our space station right now.
Building
built
under
the gas
construction.
Depot. The gas depot is really going to be the orbital gas trading depot. It's really going to be the staple of your economy. Gets you a lot of resources.
Very well.
More so than the mines. If you look at the actual income distribution, real quick, you will see that the total three mines will bring you a total of 450 income, while the gas trading depot brings you 550. Now, the gas trading depot does take the first level of Starbase, which does cost 8,000, so there's a trade-off there.
Invasion commencing.
Again, we auto-resolve because we don't have time.
Construction complete.
Alderaan, I'm actually
building under construction.
Galactic Core, I think that's
ready to go.
A Brigade Array, I didn't build three because, well, I mean, fuck, bloody look at it. It's. I could start going for Fondor. I mean, I'll just expand there first.
Understood.
I might actually start auto-resolving the space battles as well, but. Like, that's not a small fleet. Like, if I press auto-resolve right now.
Construction complete.
Okay, I did lose my custom corvettes. Those are expensive. What do I want to do? I actually want Fondor, because Fondor is one of the two planets that
complete.
Can build Star Destroyers, of course, so. You don't want to start getting that.
I go.
I can't afford the Starbase right now. We have
invasion
run out of
complete.
Cash, so what we have to do.
System control achieved. Constructing.
Now, Corita can definitely support three mines.
Acknowledged.
Belmora, that should be relatively
ready
unattended.
To go.
No, okay, so we are definitely going to do this manually. And this may actually take more than just rushing in to win. Recusants are no joke. Ah, did we lose our gladiators? That is highly unfortunate.
Yes,
see, this
Commander.
Is what you get for auto-resolving.
These vagrants stand in our way. Eliminate them to prepare for our land invasion.
Now, we do luckily still have the victory and the acclimator to actually get us some fighters. Mostly just the victory, of course. The acclimator doesn't spawn much. Okay,
orders,
so
sir.
What are we looking at?
Transmit orders. Ready
I
for
buffed
orders,
the sensor
sir.
Ping ability to have a far, far wider range, but I don't
the
think
enemy
it actually
is approaching.
Works, which is strange.
Standing by.
Coordinates
received. As you command.
Now, of course, sending
ready
in your fighters
command,
into a Recusant is going to
command,
make them
sir.
Die very, very
course
quickly.
Set.
So you really don't want to do that.
Instruction. The squadron is standing by.
That many calls
standing
out, so
by. Ready, sir.
Why are you so
in.
Slow?
Ready for orders.
You know what? You can just. You guys can just stay
right.
There.
Targeting at maximum
ready
firepower.
Ready for duty.
I have something set up incorrectly. No, max speed 3.
Flank speed. Pressing the attack.
Dire squadron
no,
standing by.
Cruiser standing by.
Right, let's get rid of that.
Our target fire is the laser cannons.
Yes, sir.
Roger that. Initiating attack.
Now, of course,
ready,
the acclimator is very well suited for that with its heavy proton torpedoes, which are the same proton torpedoes that the MC-30 also fires.
The lasers are our target.
Ah. Right.
Ready for your orders?
I forgot about
what is your order?
Laser.
As you will.
The Rexxon, of course, does have a point defense ability, which, as you can see, it is currently wrecking the...
I'm taking hits.
...the missiles. Though it does have a cooldown. Okay, so we've worn down the point defense ability, and now it can...
Roger that.
Get the...
Our laser cannon.
It's not going to get away, even if it does run. Of course, our ships have the Star Destroyers. We do have longer range, slower firing weapons, but longer range. So we'll be able to run.
Form up.
No need to get in closer. Everything should be in range. And everything that isn't can target something else. Once this is down, we can pop the result. I think we got rid of all
awaiting
the combats,
orders.
Except for that one.
Holding fire.
Ready, sir.
Maximum firepower.
We're in attack position.
Coming about.
Okay, auto-resolve time.
Intercepting.
Again, sorry guys, I hate to be auto-resolving basically everything, but this is basically a short walkthrough on how to actually get your Galactic Conquest going.
It will be done.
Remember, the name of the game is Capturing Planets.
Building
that is
under construction.
We're able
invasion
to afford
commencing.
A starbase.
System control
probably
achieved.
Should have built. Oh, right.
Building started.
Get that.
Construction complete.
Right, so the rebels now have two planets. They expand fairly slowly at the very beginning, but it does really start to ramp up. And if you're not keeping up with your expansion
complete.
Efforts, then you will really
constructing
start losing very quickly. Now again, I can't attack Kuat because it's simply way too powerful.
Right away.
And I also think that the pathfinding in the Galactic Core is a little fucked, so it might actually take that round.
Way.
So we're going to manually move them over.
Ready to go.
Transmission received.
Construction
not
complete.
Right, the virus taken, or the rebellion
construction
taken,
complete.
Let's see. The other. It's a fairly rich starting region for the. Oh, never mind, it isn't. So that's 200, at least 100, 500, 200, 200, 500. That's a Venator. I should be able to win that. Now, as you can see, income is coming in fairly slowly, so you really gotta expand as fast as you can. I've been thinking of buffing the income
construction.
We have been padding it by adding the freighters, but again, we're not going to use that right now.
Construction complete. System control achieved. Building under construction.
Coralog really does not get you a lot of income.
Coordinates received.
And I guess we're gonna resolve anyway. Move Tarkinen. Not actually sure if that boosts the auto resolve chance.
Ready to go.
We did lose Fizz.
Moving out.
Construction complete.
Tactical battle imminent.
Lost the battle. Let's try it again.
Understood.
The adjudicator should
tactical
be able to take out
imminent.
A. Right, got it.
Construction
adjudicator
complete.
Is, of course, Admiral Piet's ship.
Construction complete.
Go on. No? God damn it, man, move over. Good. Depot.
Building started.
Starbit. Let's build that here.
Building under
I don't know
construction.
Where the rebels are going to come from. They do like to expand up here. It usually takes them a while to get here. Especially planets like Mon Calamari. It takes a while for them to
complete.
Take over.
Invasion commencing. Unit destroyed.
Good.
Planetary control achieved.
Fulnor is again like 3 build slots.
Beginning construction.
Truly really unpleasant.
Building under construction.
Bunch of ADST. Oh, actually I can build a...
Construction complete.
Let's see, what has a starbase but no depot? Nothing. Okay. You already have starbase building.
Building started.
There. I'd go for this, but this sector is quite well defended.
Constructing unit. Constructing unit.
Maybe time to start expanding to Bespin.
Construction complete.
But you need quite a bit of a fleet to actually get there, so. Actually, I don't know for how long I've been going. I guess I'll check this out. I think this is Rakata Prime. Which is great, because you can start building Sith starships there. Yeah, that's two Star Destroyers. Oh, no, wait, that's Scarif. Never mind. That will be...
Construction complete.
That will be Nakata. Oh, never mind. I'm an idiot. Scarif, something else, Rakata Prime. Rakata Prime, high priority target, Sith Interdictors. Very good.
Construction complete.
Right. Okay, so I think I'm gonna end the first part here. At the day 11, we have... I suppose this. We have 1, 2, 3... 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 planets. We are making 7,500 income a turn, and we're doing fairly well right now. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope it was somewhat educational, and I do hope you will join me for part 2, because I will be keeping this going for a little bit, and I will hopefully see you next time. Bye-bye.